Love your shirt, brother.
Go ahead and stand if you can. Let's sing Sanctuary.
Read the Word of God together. It'll be on your screen. It's entitled Assurance. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to His purpose. For whom He did foreknow, He also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom He did predestinate, them He also called, and whom He called, them He also justified, and whom He justified, them He also glorified. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not His own Son, but delivered Him up for us all, how shall He not with Him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of God. Amen. It is true and faithful. Let's remain standing and let's sing the Lord. Brother Paul.
This is a beautiful song. It's called There Was Jesus. It reminds us that Jesus is with us no matter what crisis we're
yes.
going through. Every time I tried to make it on my own, every time I tried to stand and start to fall, all those lonely roads that I have traveled on, there was Jesus.
Yeah.
When the life I built came crashing to the ground, when the friends I had were nowhere to be found, I couldn't see it then, but I can see it now. There was Jesus. In the waiting, in the searching, in the healing and the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been and where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, there was Jesus. Yes, sir. For this man who needs amazing kind of grace, for forgiveness at a price I couldn't pay. I'm not perfect, so I thank God every day. There was Jesus, there was Jesus. In the waiting, in the searching, in the healing and the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been and where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, there was Jesus on the mountain, in the valleys. There was Jesus in the shadows of the alleys. There was Jesus in the fire, in the blood. There was Jesus, always is and always was. No, I never walk alone. You are always there. In the waiting, in the searching, in the healing and the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been and where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, there was Jesus. There was Jesus. There was Jesus.
I want to pray for you that God will touch you and minister to you in your need. There are people with a lot of different things going on in their lives, and we want to remember them and pray and ask God to be with you. If you bow your heads with me, please, and let's go to the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray your power, your blessing. I pray for your healing to rest on these good folks. Father, there will be people watching us from the internet. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you would touch them, God. You know what we have need of even before we ask. And Father, by your grace and your power and your mercy and your goodness, oh God, you are good. You are so good. I pray, Father, that you'd touch them even now. I pray, Father, that you'd give your angels charge over them. Father, I pray for Mike and Diane, especially Mike, who's in the hospital room even now as I'm speaking. Father, touch him in a mighty way. Minister healing to him by the power of Jesus Christ. Father, many other folks who have come down with this virus, I pray, Father, that you would rescue them. Touch them, Lord God. We are so thankful we have not experienced a death in Burleson County. In the name of Jesus, I pray, God, that you would cause that record to stay what it is. Lord, I pray for your protection, your healing, and your hand to be upon us. We love you, Father. Thank you, Father, for hearing us as we pray. Thank you for rushing to our side as we need you. Now, Father, we want to bless the children in this congregation. Father, kids that have bright future and a hope. They have parents that love them. Parents that are doing the right thing by bringing them and exposing them to the worship of the Lord their God. Father, I pray that their lives would be rich and full and powerful. I pray that you would just guard and protect them. Lord, I pray that no weapon formed against them will ever prosper. And I pray, Father, that they would have happiness and joy would be their mainstay. I pray that they, Father, would follow you and hear your voice, even as young Samuel heard your voice in the temple. I thank you for blessing them now, being with them, and keep them safe. In Jesus' name, God's children said, Amen. Amen. Lord bless you. I want to just say something really quick. My sister and her husband, Joe Roach, the Navy chaplain that you know, he's been here. He spoke here before. Maybe we can get him out here soon. I know they're going to be deployed to Japan. God bless them. But they're excited about it, and I'm glad for that. But hopefully they're going to come through here before they do that. And if they do, I want him to speak here, whether it's going to be in here or on the trailer. But it's good to see you guys in San Diego. God bless you. Now, I'm going to say this about them. They have been watching our services every Sunday. California is very different from Texas, and they haven't had the options that you have had. So this has been their church. And Joe, Tara, and Muffin, that's their dog, welcome to service this morning. We're glad that you're with us. Love you guys. Keep safe and be careful. Amen. Now, I do want to mention this, that, of course, fireworks, we are postponing them. We believe that's wise and prudent, and it's just a smart thing to do. It would grieve my heart to hear of any of us contracting it from one of our gatherings together. And although we do spread out when we do that, we want to just take some precautions. So we will not be meeting this Saturday night out at Debbie's. Joseph, when we do Boost today, we need to make that announcement. We need to do an announcement for Boost and say those things. But we are tentatively planning this for when Pioneer meets, if they meet the Pioneer camp. And if we do that, whether they meet or not, it looks like we're going to be adding both fireworks stashes together. Joseph, do you have a picture of the fireworks? Those aren't the ones that I got, and I love it. I asked Brother Wayman to take pictures, and he took both angles. He's a man after my own heart. But he told me, he said, Brother David, I want you to know that those things are double stacked, so it's more than it looks like. That is $5,000 retail. We didn't pay that. Wayman has connections. But the show that we're going to see combined, if you counted everything together, it's about $10,000 retail. So it's going to be excellent. You're going to love it. As a matter of fact, I found out that President Trump found out what we're doing.
Bigger, bigger, bigger.
Big league.
Big league.
Big league.
Biggest, most incredible.
The talent is extraordinary.
Terrific.
Tremendous.
Tremendous.
Tremendous crowd.
You know, it's tremendous.
And they're great. They were wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Fantastic.
Unbelievable. It's so unbelievable.
Thank you, Mr. President. I don't deserve those comments, but yes, some more. Now, so that's what our fireworks show is going to be like. If you're out in the cars, it was fun. Maybe we can share that with you. Joseph, maybe you can put that on our website. But we're going to have a great time with that. Now, that is not a campaign thing. That is about our fireworks. But anyway, it's going to be a great time. Whether we meet on the 26th or later, we're going to meet, and we're going to have a wonderful, wonderful time. We're going to bring ice cream and cookies out to you where you're sitting in your lawn chairs when we do this, and it's just going to be a wonderful, wonderful time. All right. Okay. I believe it's time. Am I leaving anything out? Okay. I think it's time for us, my message to begin, and I'm going to begin right now. And today I'm going to speak on, as I spoke on last week, I spoke on freedom, and I talked a lot about our political freedom and the United States. Today, we're going to talk about our religious freedom, and I'm specifically going to be addressing the Czech experience. I'm going to be talking about the great heroes of faith for the Protestant movement and the Brethren, which the Brethren really began the Protestant movement. But I'm going to begin talking about a few people. John Wycliffe, I have an image of him. John Wycliffe was a man that was before John Huss. He lived several decades before John Huss. And John Wycliffe, in his studies in the scriptures, he came across a scripture that says, "We are saved by faith and not by works, lest any man should boast." Now, the church that he was serving, the church that he was a member of, which there was only one church, was Roman Catholicism, did not teach that. They still don't teach that we are saved by grace through faith, and it's not by works. It is not how many times we come and repeat prayers. It's not how much money we give in the offering plate. It's not how long we've served on the elder board. We are saved one way, and that is through Jesus Christ and our yielding to Him. And He wrote these things, and He had many, many works that He would write about that. And then decades later, a man named Jan Hus, or as we call him, John Hus, came along. Now, John Hus was martyred. He was murdered July the 6th in 1415 at the age of 46 years. John Hus read the writings of Wycliffe and said, you know what? He's right. And it was those writings that would condemn him to death by being burned at the stake, because he taught and preached these things in his church, lost his position with the church, was stripped of all of his titles and his position in the university at Prague, and was burned at the stake. Another man, we call him Jerome of Prague. He was a philosopher, and he was a follower of John Hus at Bethlehem Church in Czechoslovakia, in Prague. He was also burned at the stake, and this man was a philosopher and, as I said, a Hus follower. These men believed in the freedom of religion. They believed in the translation of the Word of God as written. Another man named Jan Ziska, many of you may not have heard of this guy. That is not his eye is not pixeled out. He wore an eye patch. This was a great general. I believe they're actually making a movie of him now. I forgot the actors in it, but it's a blockbuster. Jesse can't wait to see this. But Jan Ziska was a Hussite general that led the mighty Taborites. This was a fierce fighting group that actually invented tank warfare. They called them war wagons, and these war wagons were very effective in war. They would take spears and arrows, and they would put the people in these wagons and ride them into battle. This man lost his eye in battle. Later on, he lost his other eye in battle, and when he was completely blind, he said, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to go to battle anyway and continue to fight. This man was a David-type warrior. This guy said that when I'm too old and decrepit to fight, I want you, after I die, I want you to take my skin and I want you to make a drum out of my skin so that you beat that drum as you go into battle. That's a warrior. This guy also believed in religious freedom. This is what he was fighting, was to continue Protestantism, to keep people from being hunted down and killed. And then finally, a man named Martin Luther, he did not establish Lutheranism, but people followed him and called their church Lutheran. John Hus did not establish the Brethren Church. His followers did. Martin Luther read the writings of John Hus, just like John Hus did Wycliffe. And he said, you know what? I agree with that. That is correct. And then he nailed the famous theses to the doors of the temple of the church. And he was hunted down. They did not find him. He stayed in hiding. But if they would have found him, they would have burned him at the stake. Martin Luther receives credit for birthing the Protestant Reformation. But it was John Hus. I'm saying these things so that you will understand and appreciate religious freedom. Now, these men didn't experience freedom the way you and I do. We're in church. We're in the cars in the parking lot. The ones in here having to wear these masks that are restrictive. And there's other things we have to do, but we still have religious freedom. Church services, religion in Texas is still essential. They didn't have what you had. They couldn't meet and worship the way that they felt the freedom to do like you and I do. The authorities over them were cruel, they were corrupt, and they were brutal. As I mentioned, how many people that were burned at the stake. As a matter of fact, in the famous book, Fox's Book of Martyrs, a very small pamphlet, I probably ought to get some and put them in the foyer, make them available to you. It's great reading when you begin to read these great people that lived before us, what they had to endure and experience for you and I to experience religious liberty and freedom. Their sacrifices paved the way for your religious liberties. Now, I think we have do you have that, Brother Joseph? Our marker out front. Do you have did you have the thing where you could read it? It doesn't have it. Maybe I had this. No, I thought I made a copy of it, and I must have left it somewhere else. But I have a copy of what it says. out there, but what our marker says, it says that these people formed these congregations in the late 1800s, and they fled Czechoslovakia. Why? Because of religious persecution. They came to the United States of America seeking religious liberty and freedom. It is very, very important that we understand that this was not freely given to us. It was paid for by the blood of martyrs and by the blood of soldiers that fought for religious liberty. In England, my home country, there was not religious liberty. You didn't make a decision whether to tithe or give in the offering. It was taken out of your paycheck. There was one church to attend, and that was the Church of England, and that was the only choices that you had. As a matter of fact, Queen Mary, everybody have heard of Queen Mary. You've heard of the drink Bloody Mary, yeah? Well, the reason that she is called Bloody Mary is because she was responsible for killing Protestants. She was responsible for hunting down Protestants by the hundreds and the thousands and burning them and killing them and beheading them because they were pursuing religious freedom. Those leaders in Czechoslovakia, those leaders in England were cruel, they were corrupt and brutal. And what we're experiencing now with this anarchy and with Marxism that is knocking on our doors, make no mistake, my friend, this is an attempt to go after religious freedom. And if these people have their way, they will stop our religious freedom. So I want to encourage you to appreciate what we have, pray for what we have, and I'm going to tell you, vote in a manner that preserves our religious freedom. We want to preserve the liberty that we have to worship God. Galatians chapter 5 and verse 13. He's working on it. Amen. While he's working on it, I'm gonna go old school. If he gets it, you guys let me know. It's up. Thank you. Listen to what it says here. Galatians 5 and verse 1. It is for freedom. It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. So stand firm. That means do the right thing. Pursue the right ways. And do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery. One of the biggest errors that we make as a people is we think that these freedoms and liberties that we have are automatic. We think that they are perpetual. The Constitution, the Declaration of Independence says that we have unalienable rights. These are rights that cannot be modified. These are rights that are given to us by our Creator. They're rights that aren't earned. They're rights that God has given us from heaven that are unalienable. But I'm going to tell you something. We had to fight for those rights. We had to preserve those rights. And not everybody in the world has liberty and freedom. Some people live in countries where they are literally held captive by their borders. They're not allowed to travel freely. They're not allowed to minister, meet, and gather and assemble and worship God in freedom. And we shouldn't take these things for granted because we have men and women who were martyred for the cause of Christ. They were martyred for the cause of religious freedom. And this is something that we should always stay on our guard for and fight for. Galatians chapter 5 and verse 1. Number one, the first scripture says it is our call and it is God's will. Let's go to Galatians 5:13. Okay. It says, you, my brothers and sisters, were called. Called by who? Called by God. To be what? To be free. Period. Freedom is something that God wants for us. It is His plan for you to live in liberty and for you to live in freedom. Not everybody has it. Like I said, some people are held captive by their governments, but we are called. But do not use your freedom to indulge the flesh. Don't get loose and don't get careless with your liberties and freedom. Rather, serve one another humbly through and in love. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 17 says, now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's freedom. So there are three major things that we can hold on to with God. Number one, it's God's will and it's God's call for us to be free and for us to have liberty. And that, of course, includes religious freedom and liberty. Number two, we should stand firm and refuse the yoke of slavery. Do not give. Do not become lax in your responsibility as an American citizen and as a Christian. Do not take religious liberty and freedom for granted, because it's not automatic. Men and women had to die for this. They gave their lives and their blood for this. Religious leaders were martyred and burnt at the stake for the cause of freedom. I'm reminded, let me show you something. I'm reminded of the words of John Huss while this man was burning. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, I don't know that I'm that person. I don't know that I'm worthy to be that person that could have done that. But while he was being burned at the stake, this is his prayer. And that he prayed this until his lungs began to burn and his mouth was moving and you couldn't even hear after this. He said, "Lord Jesus, it is for thee that I patiently endure this cruel death. I pray thee to have mercy on my enemies." Wow. What an incredible, incredible statement. Put that back up, Joseph. I just saw what you were doing, brother. Listen, this is the, I thought you had the scripture up on, yes, there it is. This is what our sign says. It says, on a fertile land and the religious freedom denied, these people, go back, this congregation built a sanctuary at this location. The year of its former organization was in 1915, replaced by sanctuary later that year. It says that we pursued religious freedom denied us in our native European homeland, and in the informal services were held twice a year in the family home of Joseph Machat. Am I saying that right? Machat, thank you. And until 1877, when Reverend L.J. Klumsky of Washington County's Wesley District came. So we have pursued this, and it's not automatic. We could lose this. This is something that Martin Luther said of John Huss. He said early in his monastic career, Martin Luther, rummaging through the stacks of a library, happened upon a volume of sermons by John Huss, the Bohemian who had been condemned as a heretic. Luther said this: "I was overwhelmed with astonishment. I could not understand for what cause they had burnt so great a man who explained the scriptures with so much gravity and skill." So these liberties, these freedoms that we have, were paid for at a great price, and we should plead for God's Spirit to remain among us. Where 2 Corinthians chapter 3:17 says that where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. So what is one of the things that we must do? We must say, "God, we plead for your liberty. We plead for your Spirit to be amongst us." We don't want to become an empty shell of a building that meets and is cold and distant and dark and gray, where there's no emotional feelings of the presence of God. This is a great atmosphere for God's power, his strength, his joy to be. And we should always pray that his presence be here, because where his presence is, people are set free. People are unchained. Abuses go away. The horrors of our past lives are erased through the power and the freedom and the liberty of the Spirit of God. It's very, very important for us to remember these things. We are called into freedom. We are to stand firm and refuse the yoke of slavery. And also we are to plead for God's Spirit to remain in our presence, in our midst. These are the hallmarks of Christian liberty and freedom. These are the things that many people have fought for. You and I haven't. As a matter of fact, we put these masks on. We wash our hands constantly. We go to Walmart, Brookshire's, and Target, and where have you. And we feel like we're being inconvenienced. We feel like it's just really, really tough what we're going through. But my friend, no one is hunting you down. No one is arresting you and putting you in a dungeon. No one is taking you and putting you on the Isle of Patmos with a bunch of prisoners to just fend for yourself like John the Revelator was. We have great blessing. We have great liberty and great freedom. And that I am thankful for. I want you to stand with me across this building. Those in your cars, you can probably sing with us, but I thought it would be a good idea to go out with a song that is sung by Lee Greenwood, and we're going to sing it with him. And do you have it, Brother Joseph? Good. Let's sing this. This is going to be all four verses. Those that are here, you'll see it on the screen. Those in your cars, follow us the best you can. This is called My Country, 'Tis of Thee.
My country, 'tis of Thee, sweet land of liberty, of Thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside let freedom ring. My native land of the noble free, Thy name my love. I love Thy rocks and rills, Thy woods and templed hills. My heart with rapture thrills like that above.
Let music swell the breeze and ring from all the trees, sweet freedom song.
Let mortal tongues awake, let all that breathe partake, let rocks their silence break the sound, hold on. Our Father's God to Thee, author of liberty, to Thee we sing. Long may our land be bright with freedom's holy light. Protect us by Thy might, great God, our King.
And God bless America. Praise the Lord. Brother Joseph, you can put Psalms 91. Let's close again. This time, more than any week we've ever done this, this is necessary. Read with me. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. Because he hath set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. May the Lord God add blessing, reading, and power to his word. Amen. You may be seated. Now, at this time, we're going to go into our decision time of how to do this. Let me mention this, that I thought of during this process that we could go to using the three buildings, but you're still going to have to wear the mask. Doesn't matter which building you're in, you have to wear the mask indoors. But these are the decisions that we are at. I haven't mentioned several families that are here.